988街头大人物 Danny Chu。
I was featured in CNN, BBC, and now I'm in 988. 我是988街头大人物 Danny Chu。
你好，我是议会。这一期的街头大人物是日本文化达人，他以日本文化作为核心的部落格，是全球最多人浏览的部落格之一。他的 YouTube 点击率呢也有2000万那么多。他制作和主持的电视节目在亚洲和美国都可以看到，而他创造的这个动漫人物 Suenaga Mirai 是很多宅男心目中的女神。他的名字是 Danny Chu， 对，不是 Danny Tsubaki， 也不是 Danny Onizuka， 他不是一位日本人，他的爸爸和妈妈呢都是马来西亚人。他的爸爸呢正是世界著名鞋履设计师 Jimmy Chu， 但是如果不说，他真的是不会在访问中提到爸爸的名字的。
Would a son of Jimmy Chu ever possible to appear in any of your introduction?
Oh no. It's he does his thing, I do my thing, so it's there's no need for it.
How does it feel being a world-class shoemaker son?
I was brought up in a foster home, and I didn't get the time to spend time with my parents when I was younger. And when, I can't remember how old it was, but I did stay with my dad for a little bit. But for most of my life, as a teenager, I spent with my mum, basically. But I did spend time with my dad working at his shoe design studio.So, but after discovering Japanese culture, I decided that I wanted to pursue my dream. And basically, I went back to live, you know, carried on living with my mom. So, to answer your question, it's, I mean, obviously, I'm very proud of what he has done, but I don't feel special or privileged in, you know, just because of what he does.
像很多现代的双薪家庭一样哦， Danny 和爸爸妈妈相处的时间其实非常少，大多数的时间呢都是在寄养家庭里头。作为一位在英国成长的亚洲人， Danny 的童年非常不快乐，常常会被同学欺负，也没有地方可以申诉。
You mentioned that you spent a little bit of time with your dad and most of the time with your mom. So what roles your mom and dad played in shaping your growth?
This is a very interesting question. I think they fed me and gave me shelter.
You couldn't remember of any, you know, happy memories, happy moments during your childhood because you were bullied and stuff like that. How did you react to the bullies? Like, did you fight back?
So, there are times whereby I can't fight back because I'm outnumbered. And... Yeah, I mean, there's once where I tried to fight back, but there's like lots of folks and they started to beat me up. But I'm outnumbered, so I couldn't really do too much.
So you're always beaten up and stuff like that. So what did you do after that? Or, you know, you just have to heal yourself?
Yeah. That's all. Just go to a corner and cry. And there's not a lot I can do about it.
And you never complained to your parents about it?
No. I mean, they weren't around to complain to. So, and my foster parents, they weren't really interested, so...
Okay. What school meant to you back then?
School was a place where I just had to go to. I didn't know why. It was just like every day I was basically sent to school. And at 3:30 I would go home.
So, is there any subject that you are interested in, or...?
Spanish. Apparently I spoke good Spanish. I haven't mentioned this. So I had a teacher. She was actually French, but she taught Spanish. But I've forgotten all of it.
Then have you done anything that you were really proud of yourself back then?
No, not at all.
Not at all? Okay. Would you say that you were very... negative and passive person when you were young or introvert?
I guess I was more of the quiet person. So, yes, quiet person, no friends.
988街头大人物 Danny Chu.
敵は本能寺にあり
汚れた闇を越えて
别了不愉快的童年呢 Danny Chu 的人生在接触了日本电子游戏之后才真正开始。
What makes you fall for Japanese culture?
So I first became fascinated with Japanese culture through gaming machines, which is one reason why I have gaming machines out there. Unfortunately, I don't get too much time to play games these days, and I wanted to know more about the games machine, which is why I went to a Japanese bookshop to find out more about the games through magazines. Mm-hmm. And so since then, I started to discover more and more Japanese culture through magazines. And then I decided that I wanted to learn the language. And so the language is like really fascinating. But to learn the language, you need to know the culture, which is, they don't teach you things like this. You need to like know how a Japanese person thinks so that you know what to use in certain situations, basically.
一款电子游戏把 Danny Chu 带到了日本书局，他多看了一些日本杂志，就开始对日语感兴趣。 Danny Chu 只是会一点点的华语，一点点广东话，然后呢，英语才是他真正的母语。其实这三种语言都是和日语天差地远，到底要花多少的心思和努力哦，才可以将一个像外星语一样的日语熟练到可以在日本是通行无阻的生活和做生意，甚至当上电视主持人呢？
I remember you tried all means, almost all means, to learn your Japanese. For Japanese learners or language learners, what would you advise them?
One of the important things is to, I think most people, they just like read from books. You know, they read from books and they expect to be able to like pick up the language really easy. But they need to like do some more things which stimulate their senses. Well, up until like 15 years ago, humans have been learning language through speaking and writing.But these days, people are like on the keyboard. So when you're writing, obviously, as you're writing, it's like causing some sort of a chemical reaction in your brain, which helps you like remember stuff. Very different to how people are trying to learn through typing. Writing is very important. So that's one thing. But they need to do lots of different things that stimulate the senses, like speaking to people, making yourself embarrassed in front of someone. Because when you're in front of someone, you say something, and you know, you don't know whether it's right or wrong.Usually when you are embarrassed of something, your brain secretes something which enables you to memorize those embarrassing moments. So which is why when you learn words in embarrassing situations, you're more likely to learn those words a bit more.
So remember that error forever.
That's right.
Danny 的建议就是除了看书写就是语言学习里面非常重要的一环。现在其实很多人都习惯用电脑输入的方式，对脑部的刺激其实没有像书写一样有效。 Danny 呢还用了一个反式思考，就是让自己出丑。他说只要你出丑，印象就会深刻，然后呢就不会再犯同一个错误。他说的非常简单，但是他做的是比他说的多好多。首先动漫当然是他也是大部分人学日语的一个重要管道。当时他看蜡笔小新还有乱码，每当有不会的字，他就会在上角呢折起一个狗耳朵，然后找字典。如果下一次看到同一本漫画，他还是不懂那个字的意思呢，狗耳朵就会继续的折着，一直等到他记起来为止才可以折回来。当时网络不像现在一样普遍，也没有 YouTube， 他就会租日本电视节目回家看，广告也从来不会放过。当时用的还是录影带，他就用录音机呢把电视节目的声音给录下来，那出门的时候也可以听。在他很重视写的这个部分，他会写大大张的日语汉字表，贴满每一面墙，每一个汉字呢都有日文注音，而且还会填上帮助他联想学习的事物。无论是上课啊、考试啊、和别人沟通交流，还有看很多美女的杂志呢，这些学习的日语的部分都是不可以少的。当时的 Danny Chu 戴着眼镜，头发中分，投入在他自己的日本幻想世界当中，或许就是我们印象中的宅男 Otaku。 那他自己到底怎么诠释 Otaku， 待会回来跟你分享。
こんにちは、末永未来です。これから皆さんと一緒に日本語の勉強をしていきたいと思います。
Otaku 在 Wikipedia 上的定义是 A Japanese term used to refer to people with obsessive interest, particularly anime, manga or video games。 在华文的世界呢，我们称他们为宅男，认为他们就是那些蹲在家里不出门的隐蔽青年，生活里头只有动漫和网络。 Danny Chu 可以说是宅男的偶像。那我们来听听他怎么看 otaku。
Can you define otaku for us?
I think there's many different definitions. or understandings of the word otaku. So you have like wine otaku. This is directly translated to wine geek, okay? Or train otaku, densha otaku, or train geek, which are people who are like really passionate about certain subjects. So like a wine geek, he knows everything there is to know about like wine. He knows, he can take a sip and he can tell you what year it's from, so. So it's basically someone who's like very passionate about something. So otaku is basically somebody who's like very focused on like a particular subject. It could be like anime or dolls or whatever. But then I think there are like different, obviously there are different understandings. So there's one understanding whereby people think otaku are obsessed people who like cartoons and like childish things. So, but I think that's, you know, it's
misconception?
I wouldn't call it a misconception. I think it's their conception of what this word is. And I think it's fine. Because what I believe in is that people don't understand, they don't matter. It doesn't matter. People don't understand, don't matter, basically. People who do matter are people who do understand. And that's where I want to like, focus my efforts on. Mm. So it's not convincing people who don't understand.
Okay, so would you call yourself an otaku?
Yes, yes.
You are. Some of our understanding, otakus, they stay in front of the computer for hours, or, you know, manga for hours, they don't come out from room. Mm. Do you have, or did you have these days?
Well, not really, no. I am in the office for like a long periods of time while working, but if it's like locked in a room like and don't come out, no, I don't fall into that category.
Danny 认为自己是一位 otaku， 但不是我们印象中那种三步不出闺门的宅男。在他的认知里， otaku 是指对某件事物或者是某个领域非常热忱、非常专注。对于那些不认同 otaku 或者是把 otaku 看作是疯狂啊、幼稚的人，他觉得一点都不重要，也不需要得到那些人的理解。当然，不得人理解的人经常就会被标签为一个疯狂的人。
Do people around you think that you are crazy or weird?
I think there are lots of people who do think I'm crazy and weird. Like the person who I spoke about just now, Tim Ferriss, he has like a huge following around the world, but he's got lots of haters as well. And so I've got lots of people who hate me as well, and they are people who don't understand, so they don't matter. They usually have attacks on me. And so these attacks will help me develop myself in many different ways based on a different type of attack.
最強の敵に立ち向かう最強のチームを育てよう君は全てを手に入れる稲妻イレブンスリー世界への挑戦ジ・オーガ冬休みは稲妻で熱くなれ。
作为宅男们的偶像哦 ，Danny Chu 也有自己最爱的游戏。
What's your favorite game or manga?
There's a shooting game called Axe Lane by Konami. That's a very memorable Super Famicom game.
Arms installation is complete. Good luck.
And anime would be Macross, the original movie, which is a title which sticks out in my mind.
だけど、マクロスの人がいれば、
地球は全滅したのよ。相手は100億の人間をあっという間に滅ぼせる敵なのよ。
You play only Japanese games? Do you play like Diablo?
Sometimes I play iPhone games. There's one called Cut the Rope.
Yes, the smart games.
除了是好多人的偶像 ，Danny Chu 呢也是一个疯狂的歌迷。他的最爱包括了西洋天后 Kylie Minogue， 还有日本女优兼歌手 Nishida Hikaru 西田光。
You had Kylie Minogue and Hikaru Nishida on your wall, right? And do you think like having your own dream girl is very important to you?
Nishida Hikaru, she motivated me to learn more Japanese because I wanted to know more about her, but the information was only in Japanese. So by learning more Japanese, I could know more about her. So the answer to your question is yes. I think for her, she was in lots of dramas, which I watched and learned Japanese from. She sang lots of songs, which I listened to. And I think when you're a young boy, you like to look at like nice, pretty girls anyway.So she kind of like made my life happy at the time.
And you were really one of the craziest fans, you know, you take glades and stuff. Would you mind to share some of your crazy stories?
So for Nishida Hikaru, I chased after her on rollerblades. I got beaten up by her guards. And I gave her flowers. And for Kylie Minogue, I would wait outside the TV studio for like 13 hours just to get a wave. Is it so tough? To a fan, it's like so satisfying when they look at you and they wave at you. It's just, oh, it's been worth it waiting 13 hours for absolutely nothing.
是的 Danny Chu 呢曾经为了一睹凯莉米诺在电视台外等了14个小时他为了要送一束花给西田光他就踩着这个 rollerblades 啊直拍轮车追西田光的车还因此呢被守卫围殴天应该是怜悯他吧眼看他追不上这个西田光的车了前面却是一个刚刚转红的红绿灯他被打到爬起来之后呢再一次追上去花就递到了西田光的手中这也是为什么 Danny Chu 作为一个过来人非常非常照顾他的粉丝
So this is the reason why so today there's going to be 500 people coming I've never had a culture Japan night with so many people Today I really want to try to get to meet as many people as I can So usually it takes me 5 hours to get through 200 people But today I've only got 5 hours and I need to get through 500 people So that's 500 people an hour, which is probably a few people
One hour, yeah, yeah.
刚刚听到的是 Danny Chu 有多么疯狂热爱日本文化到底这种狂热怎么样帮助他成为今天的 Danny Chu 明天我们继续和他聊988街头大人物 Danny Chu
I was featured in CNN, BBC and now I'm in 988我是988街头大人物 Danny Chu
或许很多人想象不到一位宅男后来会成为曾经在各大跨国企业工作的出色人才这是因为 Danny Chu 所诠释的 Otaku 是对兴趣的专注而不是盲目的沉迷他的工作经验非常丰富都是他迈向日本梦的这个道路他在英国一间叫做 Ikeda 的日本餐厅当服务员就是那种打烂盘子要被老板扣钱的日子那凭着他流利的日语呢后来就转到了希特洛机场的日本航空柜台工作这一些 part-time 日子让他多了很多练习日语的机会他的良好表现被上司赏识全职在日本航空上班维系航空预订系统他善用这个机会自学 HTML 并建立公司内部网络同时他也自学很多设计软件等等接着真正去到日本了到 Nature Japan eBay 因为 Amazon 还去了西雅图工作再回到日本的 Microsoft 在不同的地方工作给了他不同的养分
What have you learned from the experiences with these big companies?
So working in a corporate company, I think it's a great experience. Get to work with lots of different people. Well, depending on the corporate company you're working in, you get to work with like, folks like in international locales as well, and of like very different ranks. So I was brought into Amazon, and I was like managing about roughly 30 heads. And this is my first time like managing so many people. There's like people with lots of different skills, different personalities, good groups, which stick together, people which like do things on their own,People, they argue with each other. Some people are really difficult to work with, and so on and so on. So it's you know, really challenging to manage like, all of these different factors, especially when it comes to people management. But I learned on the job that I was a people manager. And obviously, while I was learning on the job, I was able to keep a very highly motivated team in my company. And the turnover rate on my group was one of the lowest in the whole company. So that's one thing I learned. Another thing I learned was that I learned communication skills. So there's lots of different people that I have to communicate with. More subordinates, with peers and people overseas as well. There are like subordinates who like don't listen. There are like peers who don't care. And there's a wide variety of like people you have to deal with. So that that helped my career.Lots of
food. What have you observed across different working cultures, like from different countries?
I find, generally speaking, this is not a blanket answer. Many folks who I worked with at Amazon, they would finish work early so that they could go skiing.
Skiing?
Yes, because in Seattle.If you just drive like an hour, so you can like go to like a mountain, like a nice mountain to go skiing and so forth. All right, it's 3 o'clock. Let's go ski.
3 o'clock?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, a bit more laid back. Mm. And maybe it's because Seattle is like a laid back town. I think like folks in Japan, they tend to like work much longer hours. But sometimes there are folks in Japan which they work longer hours, but then they're not exactly efficient. They work the hours, but they're not doing the work. They could be doing the work in like 3 hours, but spreading out between like 11 hours.
They might be surfing internet or watching TV.
It's not that they're slacking off. It's they're not being efficient in their work, basically.
Okay.
So, and it could, most of the times, because their superiors or their peers are still at work, basically. Mm.
What about your own company?
So for my staff, I ask them to work 8:30 until 5:30. So they may stay until 6, if it's like very busy, they'll stay until like whatever. But usually by 6:30, they're off and they're doing their own thing.
Oh, that's very good. I mean, I think that's really good in Japan, right?
Mm, yes.
西雅图人可以下午三点就去滑雪，日本人呢要加班却未必有效率，这些经验都让他对自己的公司的作业方式有不同的定义。那除了日本、英国、西雅图，他对马来西亚其实也有一种独特情怀。
What do you think about Malaysia?
So when I was younger, I did manage to spend some months in Malaysia. And I think when you're young, your senses are more sensitive.So you tend to remember sights and sounds much more vividly. So when I come back to Malaysia, like all the smells, all the sounds, they are very nostalgic for me whenever I come back to Malaysia. And so I feel that I have lots of readers and viewers over here, and I would like to come back here more often to spend time.
ちょっと待ってよ
中庭は海にあっさり部屋を抜け出して
矛盾してる
盛り上がってきちゃったね矛盾を打ち抜け論破しろ弾丸論破お前らもやる
Lady Chu 2004年在西雅图 Amazon 工作的时候呢，开启了他的部落格生涯。在初期，他 po 的都是 Gundam 模型的消息啊，日本动漫人物啊，或者是他在日本的生活，就是一个属于日本宅男的部落格啦。但是后来，他的部落格越来越丰富哦，他投资了一架相机去报道和拍摄不同的文化活动，部落格的页面也越来越方便。比如，如果你要对一张照片发表意见哦，不需要按什么留言信箱或者是栏目，只需要点在照片上就可以留言了。看来这一段西雅图工作生活真的比较闲，因为除了正职和部落格，他还可以学 programming 制作网站赚外快。这样赚外快的设立网站工作，却成了他离开 Microsoft 自立门户的开始。
Can you tell us more about your working experience? Because I think you are juggling a few stuff together.
So, spend most of my time working on the internet.Doing aviation at Japan Airlines, website manager for Amazon, product manager for Microsoft. And so my web experience has basically enabled me to create my own web platform, which we call Mirai Gaia. And basically this platform enables me to do pretty much anything. The vision was to have a web platform that can do anything. It can do e-commerce,It can do consumer-generated media, it can do publishing, and so on and so on. So that's the vision of Mirai Gaia, and we built something which enabled us to do that. And the version we're using now is our second generation Mirai Gaia. We're now working on our third generation Mirai Gaia, which will enable us to do stuff even more quicker with efficiency, basically. Mm.So that's all the internet stuff that we've been doing, and I'm also developing my own products, like Japanese landing cards and other merchandise as well. So, and then there's TV shows as well. So it is a bit difficult to like balance it in sometimes, but I guess it's usually placing priorities to...projects which have the most return. Not in terms of money, but in terms of, it could be like marketing, it could be gaining readers, or so on and so on.
Danny 除了要打理 Mirai Gaia 这一个网络平台，还创造了自己的动漫人物 Suenaga Mirai， 制作动漫日语小卡片等等的周边商品，主持日本电视节目。但是提到主持节目，实在令我非常好奇，一名宅男怎么能走出电脑世界，走进人群呢？
You mentioned that you were quiet. Are you still a quiet person now?
I can be.
You can be.
Especially when I'm sleepy.
Okay.
Something is leaking out. Which is why I'm a bit quiet.
Because you need to be a TV host. Does it actually contradict?
So yeah, I mean, I never thought I would end up being a TV host. So it was difficult to get into. But I think what has enabled me to do it is to focus on what I like doing, which is to share what I like and am knowledgeable about. I mean, obviously when I go on stage,I get like butterflies in my stomach, but now I'm much more used to it after doing like lots of MCing.
Okay. Have you had any skills or any smart techniques that helped you in the beginning stage? Where
not the beginning, but I think the things that help me now is trying not to cover up mistakes, trying not to look professional.
Oh.
When you try to look professional and something goes wrong, you're really silly. You do. So.So yesterday we had to move a table to the middle of the stage because we needed the laptop, and they wanted to turn the lights down and move it onto stage. But even if you turn the lights down, you can still see there's people are trying to move a table to the stage and trying to cover up the fact that you're trying to move a table and trying to look professional. It just looks really silly. So I was like very open to the crowd. You know, we have a laptop over there.It doesn't reach, please excuse my comrades as they move it onto the stage. And so that went absolutely fine. So if something goes wrong, don't try to look pro when things go wrong, because
it's very obvious.
Yeah, you look stupid.
Newcomer! Did Iwa-chan no kaizoku dan to mo tatakaen no ka? One Piece Giganto Battle, yoyaku da!
从 Danny Chu 的故事当中可以发现，他一直都在汲汲营营，从来没有停下来。
It might be easy and it might be tough. Where do you work?
So my wife and I, we buy the lottery. And the lottery is to win something like a few billion yen. And sometimes we buy the lottery and we would say, okay, check the nice numbers, check the nice numbers. But we always say to each other, even though we win, you know, our lifestyle probably won't change too much. We may be able to hire more staff.Or buy a bigger place, bigger buy a bigger office, but it's not going to change what we do at all. Obviously, we need money to like run the company and to like buy some luxuries in life, but money's not the reason why we're here. And besides, if you don't spend the money, you're going to get taxed anyway.
Yeah.
So basically, any money that comes back into the company, we have to use it and put it back into the company and basically grow. So for me, working is more of achieving goals.So I think like lots of different humans, they live for like certain different things. So there's like Maslow's triangle. So at the top is, at the bottom there's like food and shelter. And as you go up, there's like self-esteem and so on. So for me, it's, I think it's more achievement. I like to like achieve different things in life, even though it's like self-achievement which nobody knows about, or an achievement which like everybody knows about.
工作对他而言是为了成就感，即便中了头奖也不见得会放弃工作。当然很重要的就是他的工作就是他的兴趣。
Are you a workaholic?
I think because my job is so close to my hobbies. So I like anime and I'm making anime. I like figures and I'm designing and making figures. I like dolls. I'm not designing dolls yet, but I'm designing their clothes and manufacturing them. Because my work and my hobbies is like so entwined with each otherWhen I'm working, I don't feel like I'm working all the time. But to answer your question, if I had to like say yes or no, I would guess it was a yes. Because I am doing stuff constantly, Saturdays and Sundays, from morning until night.
作为老板 ,Danny Chu 要看到的是下属对这份工作的热忱以及自主独立。
What do you look for in your employees?
So I like folks, I don't like to micromanage folks. I want folks to be able to take something and run with it, basically.Looking for people who don't require micromanagement.
So what is the interview question that you must ask whenever you interview
people? So the way I interview people is that I usually choose candidates who make themselves known that they're interested in working for the company. I don't really hire people who don't know anything about the company or who I have to convince to join the company. So the people who I've hired in the past have like done things for me. So for example, I've got one artist, he works on Mirai Millennium. Mm. And he drew like a fan art. He posted it to my website. I thought it was absolutely fantastic. So I contacted him, and after a while of doing work for me, he works for me full time. So this is one guy, he approached me in Singapore, and he had his laptop and he had it open and said, look, I've done this, and it's like a picture of my master character. Yeah. So I said, oh, okay, that looks good. But I needed more than just a person who could just draw. So I gave him like lots of tasks. I want you to learn HTML in 3 hours. I want you to set up a server by tomorrow morning. And so this particular person, he like passed all the tests. And so he now works for me as well. Somebody who can like pick things up like very easily, pick up basic concepts easily. People who like get it.
People who are smart.
Yes.
一位双亲来自马来西亚的英国人要在日本做生意其实很不简单，会说日语，了解日本，结识人脉非常重要。
So I felt that I succeeded in doing business in Japan, not necessarily making money in Japan, but doing business in Japan. So if somebody goes, let's say I'm a person who can't speak Japanese, I bring along a translator and I want to convey something to a Japanese person. If I have to go through the translator, there are some nuances that can be lost.Or, you know, the translator could be saying something completely different. So by being able to speak on a very native level, that's helped me to engage with Japanese folks with my business openings. So one of the things I always try to do is do business directly with the boss, the boss of the company. So decisions are obviously made quicker because...If I'm speaking to a boss and we agree on something, the decision is top down. Mm-hmm. If I speak to some sales guy, then the decision has to like go through a huge chain, and it's a waste of my time. I guess it's a waste of their time as well. Mm-hmm. And it's just non-productive. Mm-hmm. Because I only have like one member of staff, and we just need to like make sure that we're focused on things which have a larger return on investment.
Okay.Probably to a lot of people, it's difficult to get direct to the boss. Mm. So how do you do that? Mm.
I think the way I've been noticed by particular bosses is through basically sharing my passion for Japanese culture. I work with the boss of a company called Bushi Road. They do lots of cards, card games across the world. They have a game called Vanguard. And for example, I created a large...user base, and many of those folks are, let's say I write about cards, I attract lots of people who are interested in card games, and somehow or another the big bosses of all these companies, they know that I am talking about their problems, so they want to connect with me basically. Mm. So that's one method. Mm. And proactively networking with people at different eventsWill basically grow your network so that, you know, especially in Japan, to do business in Japan, you need to like know people who will introduce each other to people. Through Japanese culture, they generally don't like doing business with people who they don't know.
Okay.
So, but if it's through an introduction, then it's, oh, I know you, so this person must be trustworthy. Mm-hmm. So.I guess that's the same around the world, especially with Japan.
魔法の本でね、調べるんだよ。見つけた。こう書いて。
我一直在想哦，除了一些虚拟世界的人物，还有遥不可及的偶像 ，Daddy Chu 好像没有提到任何人对他的生命带来什么样的影响，包括他的父母也不见得占有非常重要的一席之位。
Who is your role model?
Role model, No, there's no one I really look
up to.
No one person that I look up to. Only people who I look up to are people who are able to basically forge forward in any given situation. So there's one guy who I find very interesting. His name is Tim Ferriss. He wrote a book called The 4-Hour Work Week. I think you both share a lot of similarities in our working lifestyle and the sort of things that we do in terms of time management, managing other people, managing yourself, and so on. There is actually. There's the boss of a company called Good Smile Company. His name is Aki Takanori, and he is 13. He's like 1 year older than me, but he's built a huge following. So he makes figurines, like toys, and he has people from all over the world who enjoy his products. And lots of his customers are my readers at the same time as well. And he's able to bring lots of people together through his products. And I think he has been able to change the world. And so he is actually somebody who I do love.
Danny Chu 会欣赏的对象其实是很像他自己的 Tim Ferriss 和很像未来的自己的 Aki Takanori， 也就是说他欣赏的其实是他自己，当然还有他的老婆。
Is your wife your dream girl?
Oh yes, so she is Shanghainese. I met her in London when we was working in a Japanese restaurant. After shortly meeting, we moved out. I moved out from my mum's place. We got a little small place, very small place. So we lived there for a while, and we got married shortly after. And she's very supportive of what I do. And you know, I think with all couples have their arguments. We always make up, no matter how big the argument is. And we've been together for, I think it's our 14th year? I can't remember.
Uh-oh.
But it's been so long that it doesn't matter.
Okay. How would you describe yourself as a man, or as a boyfriend, or as a husband?
I think someone who's probably a bit selfish in terms that if I have a goal, I just have to fill it, actually, no matter what. And there may be some things I need to like, do on the side, but I tend to forget and I try to aim for the goal. Sometimes I probably take my wife for granted too much.
In terms of?
In terms of, I don't know, small things like, I don't know, I'm filming and, hey, can you carry this, or whatever. Okay, can you take a picture for me from this angle while I'm doing this interview, or something like that.
But she never complains about it?
She would complain sometimes when I do too much. So, like yesterday I was like signing for like some folks. The queue was like really, really long. And after doing it for an hour and a half, so I was like standing up there, just signing and saying hello to her. She said, look, you should take a break. And I said, no, I'm okay. What to do until I fall over? And she said, no, you have to take a rest. So things like that. You know, she cares about me, she wants me to rest. But I want to make sure because I don't travel to Malaysia that often, I want to make sure I meet everyone. So I mean, I have my reasons for doing it. But obviously I understand my wife's point of view as well.
Are you a romantic person?
Kind of.
What have you done for your wife?
It may be very standard, but flowers for wifey. We play lots of games with each other. We like to scare each other. So when I hear her coming back, I would hide somewhere.
Even to now.
Yeah. So it's quite funny actually. And sometimes she would scare me as well.
Okay.
So we play lots of those games.
Her dad's very cute. Yes. Just out of curiosity, is your wife your first love as well?
I've had kind of girlfriends in the past.
Kind of
girlfriends. Or people who I have been fond of. But my wife was the first person who I met that I would think about like all the time. So I remember when we first met, and then I had to like go to Malaysia for a little bit, and I just like thought about it all the time. I'll go to the beach, I'll write her name in the sand, and lie next to her, take a photo of her.
In your career, you must have met a lot of really pretty girls and hot girls, and Have your wife ever worried about it?
No, I don't think so.
Never.
If I see a cute girl, I say, oh, she's cute. But I think for me, life is too short for me to bother about trying to have relationships with like lots of different girls. Mm. So I found my girl already.
如果 Danny Chu 的不快乐回忆都在童年，那他痛苦的回忆应该就是发现自己患上了颈椎疝疾病的那一刻。
How does the disease actually impact on you?
So, when I first was diagnosed with spinal hernia, I was so depressed, I just couldn't do anything at all. Basically, the doctor said, well, one day maybe you can't walk, because the cartilage between your bones slowly disappears and the bones will start rubbing together, it's going to be so painful. And if you do operation, you know, it may go well, it may not go well, or they may need to cut a nerve so they can't feel anything in your legs. But then after a while, rather than be depressed for the rest of my life, I can enjoy what I have left of being healthy. And then if I hit a period whereby I can't walk anymore, then at least I've enjoyed some of my life. But for today, it basically hurts when I bend down. So when I bend down, I always hold my knees. But in Japanese culture, you have to bend down a lot when you meet people. So when I bend, it hurts. But I've learned to live with pain. So it's not getting better, it's not getting any worse. I mean, it gets worse depending on the climate, I think, when it's very cold. Mm.
当然有老婆在身边令他不再害怕。
We've made an agreement that we're going to die on the same day. So we're going to hook ourselves up to machines and turn them off. Like, there's a film called Bicentennial Man. Mm-hmm. And this is robot.And he falls in love with a human. And the human, she changes lots of her body parts, so she's like half robot as well. And they're both attached to this machine right at the end, and they're both... I think he dies first, and then she joins him by turning the switch as well. So we've decided to do that.
988街头大人物 Danny Chu